Metro, which is a great season for next year. I'd first like to acknowledge and recognize also our community outreach and engagement programs here at PPAC. We're very proud of our programs, and we're going to increase them as time goes on. But I'd like to acknowledge the experience PPAC, which brings 10th grade students, all 10th grade students in the state, into a live Broadway show. We had 5,000 students attend this year, and next year we'll have three presentations and have over 6,000. Art Showcase, which brings in middle school and elementary school students into PPAC for local and national performers. We've had five shows this year, which will total about 17,000 students, and six shows next year, which will be over 20,000 students, which is about half in attendance and half virtual. We have Disney in Schools, which is created by Disney and elementary schools. We have four schools this year and five schools program for next year. Next stop, Broadway, which is our summer program, intensive training for students in Broadway musicals. We had 100 last year. We're hoping for 200 this year. Books to Broadway, which is the program which ties students and then teachers into an actual study work program, which we had 500 students this past year. Ocean State Awards, which is a new program. 11 high schools were in competition. 650 students. There'll be awards presentation in June, and the winners will go to the Nationals. Also, we have servicemen, tickets for servicemen, free to Broadway shows, and we have a summer scholarship program for students to go to summer programs. I'd also like to announce that on March 15th, 2 days before the Holy Day, St. Patrick's Day, we have the St. Patrick's Day Rose Party here at noontime with Peter Kaczynski and with Kevin Doyle, and that's free to the public. Everybody's welcome. And I'd like to thank our sponsors, our donors, for all these programs for the community. They enrich people's lives and our memorable experiences for all. I would like to acknowledge Janet Fogarty, Gabrielle Caprio, Cindy Laughlin for their work on the board, on all these programs, and also the staff, who's a great staff here at PPAC, Alan and Judy, PJ, Stephanie, Anthony, Betsy, Claudia, Janice, Dana, Ricky, all of the senior staff and all of the staff here, under the leadership of our great CEO, Lynn Singleton. Let's have a hand for the staff and for Lynn.
Gave your money back, no questions asked. We did that for all of 2021.
We did the vaccination routine and the mask, and believe me, there was no winning that war. But we got through it, and I congratulate not only my full-time staff, but my part-time staff, because everybody had an opinion, and social media is a difficult thing to deal with. So we went to the war, got to the other side, and then last fall, we reopened with Tina, and if you didn't see it, it was quite something. And we were back in full force. And the other interesting thing that happened was our subscription base went from 12,100 to 13,200. A lot of pent-up demand. And business this year, quite frankly, after Tina, I won't mention all the shows because I'll forget some, has been exceptional. And as we went to the COVID war and the COVID reconstruction, we did not cancel, and once again I credit it to the staff and for the Broadway shows, we did not cancel or postpone one Broadway show because of COVID. We had a snow event with Jesus Christ Superstar, and if you were around this year, we had a technical problem with Jagged Little Pill. The sets didn't move for a while, so we had to cancel one night of that. The only COVID experience we had as far as a cancellation was Ringo Starr. God bless Ringo, who's 82 years old. I think we canceled it 20 times, and we kept moving it. And we finally did Ringo, I think, last summer, because there was a tour. He just kept moving it down the road. I think he wanted to get out of the house. So we did the show, and 3 or 4 days after we did the show, Ringo came down with COVID, and he canceled the rest of his tour. We had sold 2,900 tickets, and those 2,900 people did not ask for their money back. It was amazing. This year, like I say, the business is back. Annie, Come From Away, all of our specials have done very, very well. And those are tickets that don't have a big subscription base behind them. So you have to sell a lot of single tickets. So all that said, I would like to announce, even though I think PJ scooped me with press releases and posters, next year's Teyco White Family Foundation Broadway series. We open the national tour of Funny Girl. Then we do 2 weeks of Moulin Rouge. And then we do 2 weeks of Frozen. After that, we do Mrs. Doubtfire, Harper Lee's To Kill a Mockingbird, and Company. Interesting enough, back when To Kill a Mockingbird was on Broadway and they were politicking for the Tony Award, because they invited road presenters to a dinner. And so normally I wouldn't go to those kind of things, but Aaron Sorkin was at the dinner, so I thought I wanted to be cast on West Wing, so I was going to go. So I'm sitting there at this table with Aaron Sorkin, and the guy's going, bright man. So finally I say, where did you get the idea, Mr. Sorkin, of doing, To Kill a Mockingbird as a Broadway play? He goes, well, Lynn, the second most owned book in North America in every household is To Kill a Mockingbird. So, like the stupid Southern Baptist I am, I said, well, what's the first one? He looks at me and says, the Bible. I learned my lesson. Then, as our specials, we're doing a week of Book of Mormon, 10 shows during the holidays of the Grinch Stole Christmas, and the return of Ain't Too Proud, the life story of the Temptations. So at this point, roll the tape.
Or an encore series subscriber. Thank you for your interest and support of Theater PPAC. On behalf of the White family and all the employees at Take Up Conference Solutions, please enjoy the season.
Thank you. WPRI.org or call 401-421-ARTS.
So as Chairman Wall said when he came in and looked around, he said, you know, there are no bad shows next year. And Janice Anderson, who does all the work and the point person on the Broadway, Janice's goal is to only do winners. That's the thing. Years ago, we had a little hiccup with a revival, which we toured, which name I will not mention. But the person who's booking, we had to dismiss him. He went off to law school, so he's gone. And I was like, when anybody brings up Oklahoma, I always say, blame Norbert. I smile as I look at this. I guess we won't invite Governor DeSantos to Mrs. Doubtfire. Any questions? Oh, come on. You're too easy. Yeah, done. Go ahead.
This is your first non-musical in quite a while.
It'll do great business. And it's a great production. It played, I think, 6 weeks up in Boston and sold every ticket. And it's a big production. A lot of people on stage. I don't know about most people in the room, but I never saw it as a play. But all of us, I'm sure, have seen a number of times the movie with Gregory Peck, and that kind of reinforces it. But it's doing business. I'm trying to remember the last time we did a straight play. It's been a while. Janice, do you remember? It's been a while. But it will sell very well. There's no doubt in my mind. Other questions? You're an easy room. Well, thank you all for coming, and see you at the theater. Bye.